This is part 5 of Rational Exponents. We're going to use rational exponents to write single radical expressions. So for instance, here's an example. The cube root of y squared times the sixth root of y. So what we have are a cube root of something and a sixth root of something, and we're going to try to write that as just one radical. Alright, and we're going to use rational exponents. So we're going to begin by rewriting each of these radicals with rational exponents. So the cube root of y squared would be y to the 2/3, and the sixth root of y would be y to the 1/6. Now, we notice these have the same base. If they have the same base, then we could use the rule where we would add the exponents. So our next step is to add 2/3 plus 1/6. I'm going to go over here on the side and do my arithmetic. So I want to add 2/3 plus 1/6. So we need a common denominator, and that'll be 6. So I'm going to multiply the first fraction by 2 over 2, and that gives me 4/6 plus 1/6, which is 5/6. So this is just your side work over on the right-hand side. And now that means that if I add the exponents, 2/3 plus 1/6, this gives me y to the 5/6. Now remember, what I'm trying to do is write this as a single radical expression. So y to the 5/6 is a perfectly good answer, but I'm being asked to write this as a single radical expression. So the last thing is to go back and write this in radical form, which will be the sixth root, right, because 6 is in the denominator, of y to the 5th. And that's the answer. Often when you're doing these, you will end up having to get common denominators. But in this particular case, the base was the same. It would be a little bit different if they were not both y. You couldn't simply add the fractions because you have to have the same base to do that. But you would do a similar type of thing, and we'll get to those later in this video. All right, here's another one. Why don't you try it? Remember, the goal is to write it as a single rational expression, single radical expression. All right. So we want to start by writing them with rational exponents. So we have x to the 1/5 over x to the 1/6. So the first thing is to rewrite it as a radical to a rational expression, right? Using rational exponents. I should be saying rational exponents, not a rational expression also. All right, and then we can subtract exponents, right? So let's do that over here. We're going to do 1/5 minus 1/6. And this will be 6/30 minus 5/30, which is 1/30. So this gives me 1/30. And then we can go back and write that as a radical expression, the 30th of x. Okay. So that's how it works on that one. All right, this one's a little bit trickier. We've got the cube root of 2 times the square root of 5. So we could start out writing them with rational exponents, 2 to the 1/3 times 5 to the 1/2. But now notice the bases are different, so I can't add exponents, right? So here's the trick. If you have different bases, then what we want to do is write each fractional exponent with the same denominator. Okay, let's do that and then I'll explain why. So we want to write each of these with a common denominator. So for 1/3 and 1/2, 6 will be the common denominator. So I'm going to write this as 2 to the 2/6 times 5 to the 3/6, right? I'm writing both in that way. All right, so now watch what happens if I change these back to a radical, but they're both going to have the same root, and that's the trick of getting the common denominator. They'll both have the sixth root of something. So I'll have the sixth root of 2 squared, and I'll have the sixth root of 5 cubed as well. Well, if you've got the sixth root of one thing times the sixth root of something else, you can multiply those two things together, and that's how we get one radical. So we have the sixth root of, we need to multiply these out. How about 2 squared is 4, 5 cubed is 125. So my final answer here will be the sixth root of, oops, not 600, 500. 4 times 125 is 500. So interesting enough, even when you were adding and subtracting the exponents, you had a common denominator. But even when you have different bases, you're going to have to get that common denominator. So that's the big hint. Go for the common denominator. Okay, let's work on this one. So again, what we want to do is use rational exponents so that we could write this as a single radical. Because we have three different radicals. We have a fourth root, a square root, and a cube root. So we're going to start off by writing each of these with rational exponents. So x to the 3/4 times y to the 1/2 times 2 to the 1/3. None of these have the same base, so we're not going to be able to combine them in any other way, the way it is. And so the trick then would be to get the common denominator. So we're going to have the same root for all of them. All right, now we've got for denominators 4, 2, and 3. So the common denominator is going to be 12. All right, so we need to write each of those fractional exponents with a 12 in the denominator. Right, so 3/4. Well, I'm going to have to multiply the top and bottom by 3 over 3, right? So it gives you 9/12. For 1/2, I need to multiply that fraction by 6 over 6. That's going to give me 6/12. And for 1/3, I need to multiply by 4 over 4, so I get 4/12. Okay, so we're getting closer. Now they're all 12s. Cool? So I'm going to have the 12th root of x to the 9th, the 12th root of y to the 6th, and the 12th root of 2 to the 4th. But since they're all 12th roots, I could write it as one big radical. Oops, I don't know why I put 14. It's going to be 12ths. Okay, let's put the coefficient first. 2 to the 4th, that means 2 times 2 times 2 times 2. That's going to be 16. X to the 9th, y to the 6th. And there you go. Okay. So you've done several complicated things here, and we've done lots of different things with rational exponents. So just keep practicing.